What is up, guys? Welcome back to Boo Bros. It's me, Adrian from Losh TV, joined with Lexi. Not sure if you guys have ever seen her on Boo Bros or not, but today we are going into Universal because, one, we got an announcement, so I want to show you guys everything Horror Nights related inside this park right now. So, join me. Let's have some fun. All right, guys, we are now in the park, and as you can see, I'm going to put the speculation map on the screen right now so you guys can see this. This right here is potentially going to be a Stay and Scream location this year again, which is amazing due to the fact that one house is going to be right over here, right next to Despicable Me Minion Mayhem, and this house is speculated to be Witch. And like I said on the podcast, I think this has to do with Wicked Growth. Now, I could be wrong, this could just be witches overall, but it'll be really cool to see, and I can't wait for this Stay and Scream location to be back, because this was one of my favorites. You start right here and you just spring your way to the back. And now as we turn the corner, we have our first speculated scare zone location, and this is going to be traditional Halloween. Usually this zone is the embodiment of the entire park, like what's going on. So kind of exciting to know that this is going to be traditional Halloween, tying into the fact this is the 31st year of Halloween Horror Nights. So it's gonna be cool to see. And then right here in the Plaza of the Stars, we have what is speculated to be the Evil Dead. This hasn't been announced yet, so it's just pure speculation coming straight off of this map. So really excited to still figure out what iteration of the Evil Dead this is. Is it going to be the original films? Is it going to be the new one that releases this year? Very unsure, but hopefully we find out very soon. And now over here at the Jimmy Fallon entrance, we have Halloween. This house has already been announced and is based on the 1978 original film, but it will be different from the house that we had at HHN24 due to the fact that, one, it's in a soundstage, and two, they've already confirmed it in a panel back at Spooky Empire. So I cannot wait to see what they do to make this house different, and I can't wait for you guys to experience that haven't experienced it for the first time. Back here, we have two more house locations. On your left is going to be El Chupacabra, and then on your right is going to be Dead Man's Wharf. Now, these are both originals, meaning that we know absolutely nothing. Well, we know absolutely nothing about anything that's not announced yet, but these two, for sure, we know nothing about as of yet. Right now, if we turn to our right, we have New York, and we have our scare zone over here, which is speculated to be Candy Mutants. Now, like we've said time and time again, we're not sure exactly what this is. It's very different, and it's something that we have no idea what it can be, but it does spark my interest to figure out what it's going to be and what can happen. So who knows? Could be really cool. Also, one more thing, we have something inside of the tribute store that has really piqued my interest when it comes to Horror Nights. And here it is. It's talking about how the Tribute Theater has shed all of its previous curses. Tragedy? Despair? Could this lead to us having a similar type of tribute store for Horror Nights? Who knows? But that's just what I think. And now after exiting the tribute store, we're back in New York, and like I said, this is Candy Mutants. But before that, before the park even closes for Horror Nights, this right here is the Stay and Scream location for New York. It usually takes up the entire spot back here. They fence it off for you to come in. Of course, closer to Horror Nights, I'll give you guys more information on these Stay and Scream locations, but I'm just letting you know right now so you guys get a little bit of foreground. And now behind me here, we have the Fast and Furious location, and here's where we have our newest announced haunted house for Horror Nights this year. It was actually just announced today, so as of recording of this video, it is the newest announcement, and it is the Horrors of Blumhouse. I'm gonna call it Volume 3 because it's the third time that we have it, but the Horrors of Blumhouse featuring the Black Phone and Freaky. Now this just sounds different, but fantastic as well. I can't wait to see this. I can't wait to see how they break it up. Are they gonna do an entire film and then another film? Is it all gonna be together? Are they gonna give us like a grand finale? I just know that I'm going to watch The Black Phone tonight, so I can give you an honest opinion on that later in the video. So we'll get back to this later. And I heard there's also some merchandise. So as soon as we lap this whole park and get to hopefully Five and Dime, there should be some merch over there. So let's keep walking through this park, because there's a scare zone over in San Francisco that we should really talk about. Now as we start to walk into San Francisco, I am glad to let you guys know that the speculated scare zone to come here is Treaks and Foons. If you guys don't remember who Treaks and Foons are, I will put them on the screen right now so you guys can see what they look like. Now this looks like it's going to be a high energy fun scare zone, but Who knows? It is just speculated, so we'll see very soon. Now we're back here near the Fear Factor Live stage show. Well, it's no longer called that because, well, there's nothing here, and it was supposed to be demolished. However, those plans have been put on hold, and as of the latest speculation map, this is rumored to be Halloween Nightmare Fuel getting their second show, and I really enjoyed the last one, and I cannot wait to see what they put on this time, so we'll see what happens. Now, it goes with great heartache to say that we lost the location, and that location is the Men in Black queue. Now, this was one of my favorite house locations, but we're getting a new one, meaning that in the future, very near future, we could potentially getting more houses than normal. Now, as we continue walking past Men in Black, we get to the two Sprung Tent locations, which on your left will be the Bug House, which everyone is freaking out about and doesn't want to go through. And then on your right is something that I am very excited for, if it is true, that is Seeds of Extinction 2. Now, this was one of my favorite houses back in HHN 28. And honestly, seeing a sequel to this amazing house isn't half bad. Now, according to the speculation map, back here we have two more houses. Over here to the left, it is Universal Monsters Legends Collide, and over to the right, it is The Weeknd. However, in the recent HHN panel at Spooky Empire, they did reveal that over here this way will be The Weeknd, and then over there is Monsters Collide. Of course, The Weeknd isn't announced yet, but the speculated house that is The Weeknd will be over there, and the official Universal Monsters will be over here. Alright guys, we are now in the location that is Central Park. In here, we typically have our show, which is the Marathon of Mayhem, and on the speculation map it is also the Marathon of Mayhem. So I can't wait for this. It's one of my favorite shows to ever see at Horror Nights. The atmosphere is great, the music is great, and it's just fantastic. But also in this location we also have our Stay and Scream location, which is for the two parade buildings and the two Sprung Tents, so keep that in mind. My big question here is that across the lagoon over there, Fast and Furious, will there be a Stay and Scream location for it? Probably not, but it doesn't hurt to speculate a little bit. Now over here is where the entrance is for the Stay and Scream location in Central Park. However, over here it was walled off so we couldn't get over here. This is where our scare zone is that is speculated to be Scarecrow. Could this be tying into Scarecrow the Reaping, or is it just random scarecrows? I don't know. I can't wait to see. Maybe they'll put a barn structure out here. I'm excited to see what this turns out being. But now I need to turn around, and no, these fish are not going to be haunting your nightmares anytime soon, but we are going towards Hollywood. Here in Hollywood we have a scare zone, and it is called solely vampires, and we don't know if this is one of the vamp scare zones, if it's just traditional vampires. Same goes with everything. We got a lot of generic names. However, I can't wait to see what this molds into and becomes something so cool. But we did get our announcement today, like I told you guys. So we have some merch for the Horrors of Blumhouse inside of Five and Dime. Now, it's also over at Islands in the All Hallows Hula Boutique, but we have it here right now. All right, guys, and here's the shirt. It features the grabber from the Black Phone and then the killer from Freaky. I love this design. I love how the red and the blue mesh together. It gives it that like 3D feel. And I haven't purchased a shirt from the Horrors of Blumhouse ever, so this is going to be my first time buying a Horrors of Blumhouse shirt. It's pretty cool. I like it a lot. And then here is the ornament. It's cool, but I don't see myself buying any of the ornaments because I don't really have a Christmas tree. So, not that I don't like Christmas, I just don't really have a Christmas tree. But let's buy our shirt, and then afterwards, I can give you guys a review of this movie, because we're gonna watch it. Guys, we just finished watching The Black Phone, and I gotta say, better than I expected it to be. I went in with, like, decent expectations, not expecting the world, not expecting, like, the world's best horror film. I liked it. I won't say I loved it. There were some good horror elements, and they were used right. Meaning, the jump scares that are in this film don't feel like they're forced. You see that in a lot of horror movies, a lot of forced jump scares. This didn't feel like it had any force. It was just there for effect. And that's what a jump scare should be. Facts. Now, will this translate well to Horror Nights? I want to say maybe. I need to see how they execute it, because I was talking to Lexi about it before when we were walking out of the theater. I feel as if they can have that phone ringing and then have a scare pertaining to spoilers. If you haven't seen the movie yet, click off. Spoiler again. Spoiler. One of the dead kids. There's five dead children and one that's alive. So maybe they'll have the phone ring and then have the killer killing him, basically giving us our insight into how the killer killed them, because we don't see that in the movie. We don't see how the killer killed the kids. So
just
hit me at once. That, and maybe we'll see like black balloons scattered around. Maybe we'll see a hallway of black balloons.
I'm sure.
Like, it'll be cool.
It reminds me, if you guys have ever seen the movie Amber Alert, or like any of those movies where kids get abducted, it's exactly.
It feels like those kind of movies. I mean, I liked it. It's a solid movie. I mean, I'd watch it again right before Horror Nights to get some
ADHD. Now, is it going
to
be scary? My personal opinion, no. Like, if whatever happened in the house, like, in the movie, happens in the house, it's not going to be really scary. Like, though, obviously, like, the sounds is what gets me about Horror Nights, but, like, honestly, like, it'll be a fun house to go through, but it won't be, like, terrifying. Like, maybe something in the house that will be set up for this year. So, who knows?
We'll see.
I like the movie. It's not the best, but like Blumhouse has stepped up their
game a lot. That new intro at the beginning of the movie.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I had Michael Myers. I had stuff from like almost every Blumhouse film. It just spoke wonders to me. Anyways, I hope you guys had a fun time with us today. We had a lot of fun. Hope you did as well. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Comment down below. Subscribe if you guys haven't done so already. And stay excellent, my dudes.